Hey guys, this is Travis from Salt Lake Running Company here to talk about getting ready for a relay race. Many of you are getting ready for your first relay race and have never done an event like this before. It's very unique in the sense that you're running three times back to back to back in such a short amount of time. So doing a few simple things can really make your experience that much better or that much worse if you don't do them correctly. So let me give you just a few tips on what it is to do a relay race and how to get ready for it. There's three different phases that you can plan for and kind of chunk it up in your mind to kind of get ready for. The first phase is your actual runs. What do you need for your runs in order to get ready for these relay races? The second phase is the time in between your runs. You're going to have hours and hours to spend in between each of your runs sitting in a van with a whole bunch of people that maybe you do or do not know or do or do not like. The third phase that you've got to get ready for is the nighttime. Most of us don't spend a lot of time running at 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, but you will be doing that during a relay race. So how do you get ready for that? So during your run, it's kind of your basic stuff. You're going to need a pair of good running shoes, good running socks, and running clothing. Shorts, a t-shirt or a singlet, something along those lines is going to help you be comfortable while you're out there on your run. Now, you got to think about the time of your run, because you may be running at 1 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon when it's near 100 degrees. You may be running at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning when it's in the low 40s. And so your apparel that you choose is going to have to be different for each of your runs. And so we highly recommend you have multiple apparel options for your runs depending on the time that you're running. Now, the time in between your runs, this is kind of, this is where the difference between having a great experience and an awful experience in a relay really comes into play. While you're running, you're a runner, you know what you're doing, but the time in between can be very uncomfortable and very long if you're not prepared for it properly. So I highly recommend that you do not sit around for hours and hours and hours in your sweaty clothes that you just got done running in. Have a nice pair of pants, a nice hoodie, or a good comfortable jacket that you can wear in between your runs. Obviously, you're not going to need your jacket in between your afternoon runs, but during your nighttime runs, it's going to be very cold. You're going to be chilled from having the sweat from your previous runs kind of sitting on your skin, and so you're going to want a jacket and pants, especially during the evening time. Definitely something dry. The sooner you get out of your sweaty clothes and the sooner you get dry, the more comfortable you're going to be. I also highly, highly recommend compression sleeves or compression socks to wear in between your runs. You're going to be running and running and running, and you're going to stop and sit in the van for a lot of hours. And the compression sleeves can really help you increase the blood flow to your lower extremities and keep them from tightening up. The third thing to get ready for, like we said, is the nighttime. How do you get ready for your nighttime runs? And the key here is your safety gear. Everybody has to have their own reflective vest, no matter whether you're running or whether you're in the van and assisting another runner. If you're out of the van anytime during the nighttime hours, you have to be wearing a safety vest or you will be disqualified. So you have to have your vest. Also, a good headlamp and a good taillight can make a huge difference in your safety and your visibility. You can get a really, really cheap light and be visible from the cars, but you're not going to be able to see very well. You need to get a good headlamp, a good light that can really help you see your footing so you're not twisting an ankle, stepping in a pothole, or missing the curve on a lot of the soft shoulders that are along the course. So make sure you have a good headlamp so you can see where you're going, and then a tail light for safety. So that's the basics of getting ready for a relay. If you've got your runs prepared, if you've got your time in between prepared, and you've got your nighttime prepared, doing those three things can go a long ways to making sure that your relay experience is a good experience, not an awful experience. Thanks for watching. Check out some of our other videos. Good luck with your training out there, and check out Salt Lake Running Company for any of your relay needs or your basic running needs. And good luck. Have a good time.